It's a summer's afternoon, and at the air ambulance headquarters, the team's stock of ice lollies is feeling the heat.
Are you with the patient now?
Yeah, there's
a... And how many people are hurt?
There's just one person.
Okay, male or female?
It's male.
Dispatcher Lee is listening in on a 999 call from the M18 motorway.
And it's a motorcycle.
Yeah, male,
mid-40s,
motorcyclist. Looks like it had hydro loss riding. No other vehicle involved. We've left the motorway over the barrier. Not so injured. The only thing I'm concerned about is legs. He's got multiple open scratches.
My turn for Simon.
Yes, I'll see you.
He could bleed to death in minutes. Lee's scrambling Helimed 98.
He says just head to junction 5 off the M18.
Roger, dodge, mate.
Paramedics Paul and Tony will be on scene in 10 minutes with flying doctor Steve Rowe. But reaching the patient won't be straightforward.
Lee, I just wondered whether he's actually on the roundabout or on the motorway, if it's on the motorway, whether the highways have been informed of it.
Yeah, Helimed 98. I've been told that he's actually hit the barriers and gone over, so I believe it's off the carriageway.
Oh, there you go, on the roundabout itself, look.
Yeah.
Patients to the left of the ambulance.
Yeah, God, could be worse, could it? Yeah.
Pilot Andy must be careful not to distract drivers on the motorway.
You've got a lot of traffic moving. Also, around motorways, you get very high light stanchions, which approaching a helicopter can cause some issues getting to the scene.
I can't land on the motorway, I can't land on the roundabout.
What about that big open area at our 4 o'clock now?
Yeah. There's a lot of trees on there. I'm not happy about landing in that big circle there. People come under the bridge and see us. And,
that field in front of the yellow wagon tonight is a bit of a trek, but we definitely get up to the road from that edge of that field.
Yeah.
Tail clear of the fence.
Still clear, right.
Good left.
Tony and Steve face a long trek to their patient.
Hey, there's a police officer coming down. She's now at your left.
Not the ideal entrance to an incident, but I think it's as best we've got at the minute.
Fifty-year-old biker Ian Dawson was catapulted out of his saddle after losing consciousness. He's diabetic.
Hey guys. All right.
This young man is Ian. Witness saw the bike go up in the air as he went over the railing behind you.
Yep.
Okay, time was 10 out of 10. All the damage is low on going. Quite substantial open fractures both legs.
Ian was hurled 30 metres.
Is it been airborne? Is it the sign? There's quite a bit of blood on the right. So a bit of tissue, so I wonder whether that's what.
That's his leg.
Motorists saw what happened.
Came around to go to the services and saw this. Had a diabetic fit, hit the railings and flipped over. So we got some blankets out. Yeah, a bit shocking to see, really. Got to help him, haven't you, really? Can't leave him there, struggling.
Steve wants to straighten Ian's legs. Both are badly broken.
Right, guys, we're just going to, while you're doing that, we'll draw some ketamine. We're just wanting another box splint when helicopter lands. I've only got one.
Two off-duty nurses saved his life by putting a tourniquet on his legs.
Every time you let go, it's
cool. Yeah. So, do you want to start sneaking in some ket? And then, as soon as that's in, we'll bring this out straight. And to be honest, I might just use a sheet. Kind of a big all-over bandage, that, then.
Police have now closed the road, so Andy can land near to their patient.
Getting the good stuff in you now, sweetheart, all right?
What we're going to do, we're going to gently bring this leg out to length. OK, I know the bone's all over the place at the moment. Best place for them is in the inside.
The large dose of ketamine should help Ian cope with the pain of having his legs straightened.
Right there, Steve. Grab the foot, gentle traction on the foot, almost like you're trying to take a welly off.
He could face amputation if blood flow is not restored.
and we're just going to gently pull back on that, Steve, okay?
Pull back.
It's going to feel funny, it's going to feel horrible, actually, but just keep going. That's it, keep going. See if you can lift it up in the air a bit for us. Brilliant. Okay, great work, guys. That went in nicely. Super. Right, other leg now.
Happy time. Minute, mate, yeah.
Yeah, it'll click and clunk. Don't worry, get it out straight. Remember taking that welly boot off. Perfect. Super work, guys. That's spot on. Let's look at getting the scoop in now. Pelvic splint can go on. So, yeah, under the space under his thighs and...
Ian has survived this crash thanks to the medical skills of nurse Catherine Bebb.
When I realised there were nobody medical here, I pulled over straight away, got my nursing bag and my tourniquets, everything out, boot of my car, and come over and just tourniqueted it up and secured the bone and did best that I could.
Half an hour ago, Ian was riding home from work after a shift as a postman. Now he's on his way to hospital in Sheffield.
Can I have a window seat?
Window seat?
Only if you pre-book, I'm afraid.
Right, just keep holding it for a second.
The in-flight movie today is the Smurfs.
Are we in? Yep, that's it.
We'll get you sorted, mate, all right.
How's your pain in a minute? It hurts, does it?
Lifted. Still good left. I'll keep it on this flight, then.
We're all right.
Laser above the lights.
Thank you. Don't go for the radar, Helimate 98 Alpha.
Helimate 98 Alpha, don't go for radar. Hello, pass message.
Yeah, we're airborne now, junction 5, M18.
Dr. Steve knows his patient may face emergency surgery.
Left leg, multiple open fractures from the toes right up to the posterior calf, with a tibia protruding posteriorly through the calf. He's going to need orthopaedics and plastic surgery to try and salvage his legs. This is a limb-threatening injury.
Good left.
Hospital tests will reveal the full extent of Ian's injuries in the next hour.
What time's the helicopter getting here?
This is it. You're in it. You're living the dream.
He walks 14 miles a day on his postal round. This crash could change his life.